Now that we have seen how instruction scheduling works, let's see how it interacts with things like if conversion. Recall that if conversion works like this. We had some code, and then there is an if then else, which means there is a branch. Sometimes we do this, sometimes we do this, and then we go back to doing something after the if then else. Let's say this is the orange code, and let's say that this is the green code. Before if conversion, we can easily reschedule code within here. We can also move things around within this. We can move things around within this. And we can move things around within this. But it's hard to mix the code from these together. For example, take an instruction from here to fill a stall here, because if we end up going this way, that instruction doesn't get done. So it gets a lot more complicated. However, after if conversion, we do the stuff that was before the if then else. We then have the orange code predicated so that it only results in execution. And then we have the orange code predicated one way, green code predicated the other way, and then the stuff after the loop. And now, because this is branch-free code, and because all of these instructions really execute every time, it's just that they're predicated sometimes, we can easily take instructions from here and put them here to avoid stalls. And that's nice. We can even take instructions from here and put them here, or instructions from here and put them here. For that matter, we can even take instructions from here and put them here. So overall, we get a lot more opportunities for filling stall cycles with something useful. So if conversion is one of those things that it helps with branch prediction because you avoid branches, and it also can tremendously help the compiler in making a better schedule for a processor.